we wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Dana Berez and we are here, Allison, you and I. We are in West Virginia. We are in Charleston. We just arrived. And if you don't know, it is so beautiful. So we are here in early October and the leaves are just starting to turn. So by the time this video goes out, I'm sure that you could have the opportunity to be in peak season. And we are here with the Tourism Board of West Virginia.
We're gonna be doing a lot of great fall themed activities. We're gonna be seeing some really cool local markets, eating at some really great restaurants, and showing you what there is to do for fall in West Virginia.
So today we just arrived, so we're gonna take it pretty easy, but we are gonna go to a local market that is in Charleston. It's called Capital Market, and it's about a 15-minute walk from our hotel. We're staying at the Four Points by Sheraton, but I think we're gonna drive and just see what that market is all about. So let's get going. So we've made it to Capital Market, and this is a local market where they sell fresh produce, their apples, pumpkins. You can get like soups, fruit to go, and it is a year-round market. And the inside is situated in an old train station. So we're gonna have a look around. I see so many pumpkins, so many apples. So let's go see what they have. We took a walk around Capital Market. During the fall season, you can find your perfect fall pumpkin and other in-season fall items from local farmers. And be sure to walk inside. There you will find local produce items such as homemade jams, syrup, sauces, spices, grocery items, plus local favorite food vendors. All right, so we wandered around the Capital Market for a while. We actually got some sushi to go, which was so good. We got a dragon roll, which was, I think, shrimp, and there was like some caramelized onions on it, so it was a bit sweet, and some like mayo. It was really good. If you're looking for like local produce, like local jams, local like spices and sauces, you definitely have to go there. And now we are headed off to dinner. We are going to a restaurant called 1010 Bridge, and it was maybe like a 5-minute drive from our hotel. It specializes in Appalachian cuisine, so we're excited to try out the local flavors. It's also like a farm to table restaurant, so the restaurant does source all of their ingredients from local farmers, and I'm excited to try it out.
We were also recommended a restaurant called Noah's. That one is a little bit more fine dining, though that's another place that is really popular in this part of town and in Charleston, West Virginia.
Yeah. So let's head inside. Ten Ten Bridge was the place to be. The menu had so many things I wanted to try, but we ordered some zucchini chips, which is like a starter. And oh wow, this looks so good. And pancakes, jalapenos, hot oysters. Then for our mains, I had the steak with lobster, mac and cheese, and Brussels sprouts, and Alsenio ordered the scallops with risotto. All right, good morning everyone. We are ready to explore Charleston. So last night's dinner was delicious. How busy was the restaurant, Al? Like, it was so busy inside, and the food was so good. We had ordered these jalapeno pancakes. There was actual like jalapenos inside, and it was like a brunchy, sweet, savory, and spicy dish. It was really good. The hot oysters were amazing. Highly recommend that restaurant. It was very, very delicious. We are doing some exploring of Charleston, which is like the downtown area of West Virginia, and we are going to a really cute coffee shop right now. It's called Mia Cup of Coffee. Thank you. So I always order a regular type drink, but today I'm trying something different. I'm trying the Aztec Mocha just to get out of my comfort zone a little bit. And the lattes have come out. This is the Aztec one that I ordered. It smells so good. I am jealous though of Al's whipped cream on top. That looks really good. So we are going to just enjoy here. I'm trying this right now. That's actually so good. It is spicy because of the cayenne pepper, but I never had anything like it. And it's really delicious. The pumpkin latte here has real pumpkins in it on like things, so it's very natural, very good, and you can taste it. Definitely can taste the difference.
Definitely tastes higher quality.
Yeah. shopping. We're in Elk City and they have cute like little boutiques and things. There's also tons of like wall art around here, so we're gonna do some exploring around here. The first stop was the Vandalia Co., which specializes in homemade donuts and healthy bowls. The interior here is so cute and charming. It's perfect for either a sweet treat or a healthy lunch. Okay.
Yeah.
Homemade scratch donuts.
This is the cookies and cream.
Okay.
This is the sprinkle.
Yeah.
And this is just the traditional 42 type donut. But these ones we have, we also have a pumpkin.
So I went with a donut. They're all house made. Everything here is made from scratch. And Alsani went with the Greek bowl. Healthy option. I had to try the donut. I actually don't order donuts a lot, and this looks good. Caramel apple donut. Perfect for fall. I'm in the fall vibes here. And this place is so cutely decorated. Everything has like a cute little corner. Super caramely. Wow.
We're gonna have like
you're gonna
healthy,
love this.
Healthy and sweet.
Yeah, healthy and sweet. So we are going to stop inside Kingship Goods. They have a lot of fun things inside, so let's check it out. This store had you covered with everything West Virginia, from quirky finds, t-shirts, soaps, basically anything that you can imagine. And then we went to Base Camp Printing, which is known for their handmade letterpress prints ranging from home decor, cards, and custom prints. After some shopping, we made our way to the New River Gorge National Park, about an hour and a half drive from Charleston. If you want more of a scenic drive, take Highway 60 versus Highway 64. It'll add 15 minutes to your travel time, but it'll give you a way more scenic view. We stopped 30 minutes into our drive to check out this amazing viewpoint. We are by a gorgeous lake. And we are passing through this like adorable town. And when we came in, we saw a lot of waterfalls, and we are actually right by Cathedral Falls. We're gonna stop there next, but we're gonna take a few photos of this amazing view and take it all in. So we are stopping to get some lunch at this restaurant. They have plenty of outdoor seating and it is such a cute vibe. Time for some lunch. So I ordered a brat, also you got a quesadilla. They also have like vegan tacos and everything. And we're trying some draft beer.
Stopped at Handlebar Kitchen for a quick little lunch, and it is so cute. They have like a cute little area where you can sit outside, and basically they have all kinds of food here. They have West Virginia brats, which is what I ordered. They have vegan tacos. They have plenty of beers on drafts. So if you are in the River Gorge area, be sure to check it out. And we are just settling in before we check into our hotel. We are staying at the Adventures on the Gorge, which is in the center of where you can do whitewater rafting, a lot of adventure sports. So if you want to be in the center of it all. And the trees, when we were driving in, I wanted to stop so bad at so many different points because the trees are just starting to turn. I'm surprised actually how much they have turned already. There are some pockets of red already. So I think in about a week, 2 weeks, it's going to be stunning. If you have availability to travel in mid-October, this definitely needs to be on your list if you love catching fall foliage. So relaxing. We took the slower route here too. We took Highway 60E instead of 64. 64 is like the main like highway freeway, or how do I say it in New Jersey, turnpike. Took 60, which is more of like a one lane road, but it was more windy and you get really more like the fall foliage scenic drive. Also, we picked up some soap at the Kinship Goods store that we just were at. They had so many like unique finds, like very West. And we just got some soap, patchouli and vanilla. Smells so good, and it's coconut milk based.
It'll be the first right, and you'll see a sign that says Sunnyside Road.
All right, so we have made it to our cabin. We are staying at Adventures on the Gorge cabins, like RV sites, campgrounds that you can stay at. It's also so relaxing. So we just checked into our cabin, and it's right behind me. We are in Sunnyside 4A, and let me show you around. So we have some other cabins next to us. Let me show you the balcony first. So this is so, as you can hear, it's so quiet. All you just hear are the trees, and we have this amazing porch to take it all in. Definitely gonna be having some morning coffee there. And yeah, this is so, so peaceful. This is the inside of the cabin. We have two queen beds, desk, TV, and then over here, we have a microwave, coffee machine. Yes, so how about the coffee machine and a refrigerator? And we also have like this huge bathroom, modern bathroom. So if you're ever wondering about staying in a cabin, everything is modern and up to date. We are going to just settle in for a moment, and then we are gonna head to our first hike of the trip. We are starting our hike on the Long Point Trail. Let's do it. It is about a mile and a half one way and then a mile and a half back. So 3 miles round trip, and apparently this is one of the best hikes in the area for an amazing scenic view at the end of the hike. So you'll get rewarded with an amazing view of the whole New River Gorge. So I'm excited to see that. And it's not uphill yet, so we'll let you know if it ever gets uphill. But we are just gonna do our little walk. There. I just think these tree roots are so cool. Looks like spider webs coming through the ground. We are almost there. We saw this viewpoint over there. It's stunning. Wow. So we've made it. We can see the bridge peeking through, and there's just like nothing underneath us. It's so cool. So let's get a little bit closer. Made it to the Long Point trailhead, and The hike was not bad at all. It was mostly flat, honestly.
I thought it would be much worse. We've done other hikes. And trails, and it's nothing like this. This is really easy.
Yeah, this was very easy, and we just made it. The viewpoint is amazing. It's definitely worth to do.
So in about a week and a half, maybe 2-3 weeks, I don't know, this is going to be just filled with so many different colors. You can kind of see the colors changing right now into like a light yellow, but this view is just so beautiful. And this is the bridge that we drove across to get to our cabin. And yeah, we're just taking it all in.
So we finished up our hike and we headed back to Adventures on the Gorge where we're staying. And they have this really pretty lookout point where we're just catching the sunset right now. The lighting is so beautiful around us, and it's just beautiful. On our way to the hike that we did, we drove through Fayetteville, which is one of, I think it was ranked one of the cutest small towns in America. So tomorrow morning we're gonna do some exploring of it, but tonight we're actually eating dinner here at Adventures on the Gorge. We're going to Chetty's Pub, which is more of like a low-key place to have dinner. So I think we're gonna catch sunset and then head to dinner.
So this is the gift shop, and the restaurant that we're going to is around the corner, and there's so many cool viewpoints and like places that you can sit.
This does kind of remind me of camp. When I was little, I would go to a camp every summer for a week, probably for like 3, 4, 5 years, and this is totally giving me those vibes. So I totally appreciate that because I used to love camp. I am from Wisconsin, if you didn't know, so that was a highlight of my summer. So this is giving me all of those vibes.
art view. Oh, look, that tree is so red. This is Chetty's Pub View. Another beautiful viewpoint. And look at this fall foliage. It's bright red. So we're gonna look over the menu. And we ordered some wings. Ooh, it's been a while since we had wings. Oh my gosh. Classic buffalo. We have a beer. And the view is just stunning.
It was
so
the cruise
beautiful.
Coast.
Good morning, Al.
Good morning.
We are headed to breakfast.
We are headed to breakfast in Fayetteville. And it was so peaceful last night because, as you can see, it's very quiet. And we had a good sleep. And now we need some good coffee. So we're going to head to the downtown. It's probably like a 5-minute drive away.
We headed to the Cathedral Cafe, which is a cafe that is inside an old church. So the interior is super cool. They have tons of books everywhere. It's super cozy, and we had some breakfast. I really wanted a pancake, so I ordered one. I got a breakfast quesadilla, single pancake, and basically a bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel. Going back to my New York.
Asiago bagel.
Asiago bagel.
Did start to rain just a little bit when we were at breakfast, so we headed back to the room just for a little bit. In Fayetteville, there are so many cute little shops, so we are going to grab some lunch to go because we're going to go take it to a state park.
So we're going to grab some things go so we can have a little picnic at the park, and hopefully the rain doesn't come because there's a rain cloud coming. But we are at the Station Market and Bistro. Baby?
He's like 14 months old or something like that.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
So we've made it to Babcock State Park, and on the way here, the fall foliage is beautiful. So I'm gonna try to get some on the way back, but we are arriving in the park. We just found the mill, and as soon as we parked, it just started to rain a little bit. So we're gonna take some photos outside, but we probably will get a little soaked. It's raining, but it is so beautiful. The fall foliage over here is a bit more peaked than where we are staying. So if you drive a bit 30 minutes towards Babcock State Park, it is way more reds and oranges at this time. So we're gonna go check it out. Hopefully we are having a little picnic in the car because it is still raining just a little bit, and we're just gonna eat it in a dry place. And wow, the sandwiches look good. Apparently it was a full service restaurant before COVID, but after COVID they kind of made it into like a market. Al's sandwich, it's like a salami sandwich. I ordered a barbecue with coleslaw. View though here is just so beautiful. We have all of the fall foliage, and ooh, it is really, really good. Quite big too.
Probably one of the best sandwiches I've ever had.
Oh my god, it's actually so good because there's like something really crunchy. It's like
pickled onions.
Oh, so good. This is where we made it. Like, how picturesque is this? Isn't this stunning? And the fall foliage over here is just beautiful.
Very beautiful.
So we're going to take it all in, take some photos.
Hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun.
So there is a few trails that you can take from here. This is the Island in the Sky Trail. Because it's raining, we're going to skip it, but that I think it's just a half a mile this way. And this is the mill from a different angle.
Crazy, but things are finally right. With you and I, the future is bright.
It's time for dinner. We're checking out Pies and Pints, and they are known for unique pizzas and draft beer. So let's head inside And I think they have a little outdoor patio as well. So pies, specialty pies. There's so many different kinds. We should probably try a really unique one. Let's do it. Maybe like a regular one.
Actually, in a way.
Trying some. Al's trying some different draft beers, so I can't wait to see which one's your favorite.
Yeah, okay.
That's from right here in Fayetteville. This is our Sweetwater Blue that I was telling you about before.
Yes.
The Weathered Ground Endless Summer. So this is an IPA. Janky Juice right here by Bad Shepherd. They're from Charleston, West Virginia.
Okay.
And then the Parkersburg Last Summer, the one I was telling you about.
Okay. Having a rosé. And Endless Summer Medium IPA that Al got. And we ordered one pie, but half and half of two different flavors. Tomato, all locally grown tomatoes. And then we got this street corn. So it's corn, chipotle cream,
scallions,
cilantro, jalapeno. You're trying that one. You can tell if I'm gonna like it. And these are locally grown heirloom tomatoes. So I love that they're using local ingredients. And let's see which one I like more. So we are taking in the sunset again from where we're staying. The lighting is just so gorgeous. Look at that light. Oh, beautiful. Good morning, everyone. Have my coffee here and we woke up to this view. It's just so peaceful, and we have been packing up our things, but before we head to the airport, we do have a few activities planned that I want to do. So first, we're going to get even more coffee. We're going to go to Fayetteville yet one more time to get some coffee and light breakfast, and then we're going to do a cool scenic drive. So I showed you before the New River Gorge Bridge. There's a scenic road that you can drive. It's called Fayette Station Road, and we're going to do it. It's like a 30-minute drive, but it takes you down to the river, and you can kind of see the whitewater rafters. I don't know if there will be any today. So we're going to get some good vibes, coffee and food at Wood Iron Eatery. And there's this little house all the way up here. And this is the downtown. It's very small. It's like maybe like two streets long. They have a theater. They have cute little shops along these streets. But first, let's get some coffee.
If you don't focus, here we go.
Look at this rug. Morning coffee.
It's so good.
I ordered some hipster bread, and Al got the chicken waffles. And this coffee is so yum, so we're going to dig in.
We just finished breakfast and it was so good. All the food here has actually been really delicious, and they have a lot of like different like healthy bites as well. And like a lot of vegan and gluten-free options if you're into that. And now we are going to do a scenic drive on the Fayetteville Station Road. We're at the New River Gorge Visitor Center. That's where the road starts. So let's see what it's like.
So on the road, you can make some stops because there's amazing, really cool viewpoints. So we're right now underneath the bridge and you can see it. Also very foggy, so it's a very cool scene. And we've been driving down this whole trip to get to Fayetteville from our hotel. So.
All right, we ended our scenic drive and we've made it to the airport. So I will end the vlog here. I hope you guys enjoyed. We had such a fun time. It was so amazing just to be in nature. And the fall foliage here is one of the best. It's just, every street is so scenic. I wanted to stop so many different times just to take pictures on the road. So if you're looking for a beautiful fall foliage trip, definitely check out West Virginia. And with that, I will see you guys in the next one. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for more travel videos and be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. So with that, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.